40 years old, from Atlanta, Georgia. Played all different sports, box growing up, baseball, football. But wasn't like no high school baseball or anything. Got into softball a little bit later than everybody else. I think I was 26 at the time. Came out with a few friends, and they were like, actually, before I played a league game or two, and a buddy's like, come to Myrtle Beach, let's play with our team. And the team's called Driftwood. And went out there, had a blast, and was hooked from that point on. Played locally in D for 2 years, and went conference after 2 years of playing locally.
I didn't think you were 4 years old, man. You look in great shape.
Appreciate it, man. 6 days a week in the gym, you know, you got to.
How big are you? What do you weigh?
I'm about 265 right now. I walk around in the off season anywhere from 275 to 280.
6'2"?
6'3". Start doing my diet every January. Right, first week of January, I start my diet. February, first week of February, I start doing my cardio and just knock the pounds off. And
I I
like to go in the season about 255 to 260 range.
How long have you been in the conference?
This has been my 11th year in the conference.
Nice.
Everybody's back gets a little tight, lower back, so I stretch out. I'm a big believer in flexibility now. Wasn't always like that, but flexibility is very big and preventive. I got some compression pants for my legs. I put on, I got the massage heat back massager for my back, and I got the sports gun drill. Use that religiously, and I'm a firm believer in ice baths, so I do a lot of ice baths. And I'm standing straight up, all right? As the ball's coming in, you know, you do your stride. I got a higher leg kick and tend to drop my hands a little bit, and once this leg hits, I start turning, right? Turn as fast as I can, hard as I can, and for a straight path for the ball.
When you lift up that front leg, you were talking to one of the campers before, it's almost like you use that as a counter rotation of the hips, right?
Yep.
A little coil of the hips, show us that again.
Yep. This. As soon as it hits, I'm turning, right?
You're telling him how important it was to stay closed. When you say closed, you mean by not opening up earlier, getting the counter rotation, right?
Yep.
Talk about that a little bit.
So the biggest thing when I get in trouble is if I get my hands too far out. Because when your hands tight, you're tight, and you can generate a lot more bat speed, a lot more power. Like if you're out here, there's not a whole lot you can do, right? You're sloppy at that point. So I try to focus on keeping my hands back and keeping everything tight and close. So as soon as that leg hit, I can torque and explode.
Do you feel like when that front foot comes down, it comes down real hard with a lot of weight transfer? Talk about that a little bit.
Yeah. So I actually do a lot higher leg kick than most. KP's got a big, higher leg kick. But I was always taught, you know, old school style, that I do a high leg kick. So when it comes down, I'm coming full force forward, right? And as soon as it does, it's all in one motion. You turn. Hit them hips and generate that power. A lot of people think, you know, power comes from here. All my power comes from right here.
And you don't have an excessively long stride, but you really have explosive hips. So, I mean, just for lack of a better way of saying it, do you feel like you take a stride and your hips throw open like a baseball pitcher? Would that be the way you would describe the way your hip action is?
Yeah, definitely.
You're throwing open against the front foot?
Yep.
So then if you take all that force, how do you apply that to your hands? Where do your hands go?
So my hands, I just try to be kind of point A to point B with my hands. So if I'm dead red and I'm trying to hit a home run, I'll drop my shoulder a little bit, you know. But for the most part, I try to come through the zone A to B and snap my wrist. So, you know, it don't always happen like that because of the different heights and different speeds of the pitches. But most of the time, I'm trying to come from here to here.
Do you actually manipulate your wrist during the swing, or do you throw your hands so fast that your wrist just automatically snap? What would you say?
No, I say it manipulates. Depending on the height of the ball, if I know it's coming in a little higher, then you know you might not be able to cut it from here, so you'll have to come at a different angle. But if the ball's from knees to waist, then yeah, it's all one motion and it's snapping.
Would you say that feels like you're throwing an axe head into a tree? Palm down, palm up?
Well, I've never thought about that.
Have you ever swung an axe?
I have not swung an axe.
Like you said, the thing that we use in our show is we put a heavy bag out there. And if you were to hit the bat into the heavy bag to promote a good point of contact, is that something that would make sense to you?
Yeah. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah.
Like not so much hitting through the ball, but hitting into the ball so you aren't chasing out ahead. Does that make
exactly.
sense at all?
Yep.
And so if you bury the bat head into a heavy bag, it'd be the same as burying an axe head into a tree.
I agree with that.
Did you tell me yesterday? accident. I asked you if you ever hit an accident to a tree.
I'm talking about buy a chain. I live in the city, so I buy a chainsaw. But I have done that because I've hit into a tire before. I've never done a heavy bag, but I have hit into a tire, so I understand the concept. So as soon as that thing hits, I'm coming with everything I got in this torque, in this back leg. And this is more, as soon as this hits, it's just a trigger for this to explode with it.
But the hand's got to be back as far as you can feel comfortable.
So you can explode forward. Just like you said, it's like a rubber band. The farther you push it back, once you snap it, it'll go forward. Yeah.
Do you ever run into troubles where you're early on the ball like that?
So if I ever feel like I'm either early or late, I tune it up through the middle. So if I feel like, okay, if I'm hitting BP and I'm a little early or I'm a little late, I know if I go middle of the field, then you're meeting the ball.
Yeah, that's the strategy. You're bringing that point of contact back farther towards the catcher.
Yep. So I'll tune it up with that, and once I feel like I've adjusted my swings where it's more, then I can go start going backside where I can start.
Are you familiar with Steels? They used to have Masenko and those guys played for Steels in the day.
I know the Big Cat. Yeah, actually, I met the Big Cat through softball. I never got to see him play, but we share the same nickname. So he was the Gorilla Boy, me the Vanilla Gorilla. So. I talked to Mike. Mike's a great dude, and he was like, "Man, you can carry that nickname, man. You deserve to play."
Oh, he's awesome.
Yeah, I like old Mike.
The one thing that they used to do, I used to see Steels all the time. You know, being older, they would always take their first seven swings backside to bring that point of contact back. As the point of contact out too far is probably the biggest silent killer of a good swing.
Yes,
you know?
It will get you in trouble every time. If you're had a great time out here in spring training 2021. And hopefully next year I'll be back and I can work with everybody again and, of course, meet you again.
In the Dean Marini brand, glad to have you aboard. I mean, you're just killing the ball into the wind here today, still hitting close to 400 feet. So
appreciate it. Awesome. And be on the lookout, the Vanilla Gorilla.
Talk about the bat. This is last year's model.
Yeah, this is last year's model. So this is a 12-inch barrel with an APC. It's not the Not a Lie.
Let's get it over here. How did you come up with the nickname?
Well, it was my Instagram nickname. That's what they call me in the gym. So it was kind of came from working out, and Corny and liked the name, and he's like, "Let's roll with that." And I was like, "Cool." And we came up with the graphics. We wanted to have the best looking graphics, the best looking bat in the game. And I think we killed it last year, and it sold real well. Sold out in about 6 hours in America and about a day and a half in Canada.
You got a super cult following now.
Yeah.